Martin Shaw has been acting out the last of the King's tragic life in the stage musical Are You Lonesome Tonight? Shaw's better known here, I think, as Ray Doyle, the action man of the TV hit series The Professionals. He's won critical acclaim, though, in Britain for his portrayal of the tragic and bloated megastar. Now the smash hit musical is about to open in Australia with Marcy Hines, Linda Stoner, Peter Tupano, and lots of others. So today, please welcome its star, Martin Shaw. Welcome to Australia.
Thank you.
Not your first, you've been here a couple of times before, haven't you?
Yes.
Yes. This is a very different image for some, I will talk about The Professionals later briefly, but for someone who's used to seeing you in The Professionals.
Yes, I guess it is. But then all parts are different, you know. I mean, everything is a totally different deal. You know, you've got to examine a new person from the inside, and so the exterior will follow, and it'll be completely different whatever I do.
Yes. The hair is, I mean, so radically different. Did you actually have the hair curled for The Professionals?
Yes.
You did.
Yes.
The Elvis role, then, did you take it on as an actor, or did you take it on because of a fascination with Elvis?
Oh, entirely as an actor. I mean, I didn't know very much about Elvis at all, and I was aware of him the way everybody else was. I mean, it's almost impossible not to be. But I took it on as an actor because I read it and I thought, I can't do this, you know, which is a great reason for me for doing something.
Good challenge.
Yeah.
But you described it as a seductive role. Why was it seductive?
Well, it becomes seductive because of the audience response. I mean, it's very rare in an actor's career that you can get as many accolades and standing ovations as I have been blessed with since I've been doing this part. And it's also rare for you to get so much audience involvement. I mean, I can hear people sobbing, you know, when I'm doing it. And it's very rare to get that sort of contact with an audience.
Why do you think that is? Do you think it is because of Elvis rather than because of Martin Shaw's performance?
It's not fair to ask me to comment on my own performance.
But I've just wondered, if you were doing a play about anyone else almost.
I think that's the main thing. I mean, Elvis was such an attractive figure. I mean, more than that. I mean, he pulled people into him because of his heart. You know, this man, he made people feel that they were loved. And I hope that's what I'm conveying when I'm doing the part. I mean, that's the one area of his personality that I wanted to put across to people, that you are important, you are loved. And that he had this sort of gentle irony about himself and about life. And so to give that to people during a show, when they know that it's going to be taken away from them, they know that he's going to die, I think it's very sad for people.
Yes, the reason I asked the question about though a moment ago was I did a story some years back at Graceland's on the anniversary. It must have been the 7th anniversary, I think. And there are many Australians there as well, but there were thousands of people who were filing by the grave. And I just wondered, that's the reason I asked. Even the playwright has referred to, your playwright has referred to Elvis as the Greek god of the 20th century.
Yes, that's true. It's true. He was and he is treated like a god. I mean, a lot of the fans in England, you know, the official fan clubs, he's almost like a religious figure.
Yes. The role itself, again, I've seen you describe it as you're saying that my body hurts all the time from the physical and emotional strain of it.
Mm.
Why?
I don't know exactly why. I mean, I can make a few educated guesses. I think part of it is because I weigh 11 stone and he weighed 18 stone. And so my consciousness has to expand, if you like, into a different shape. Also, I'm using completely different muscles, you know, to the diaphragm. I don't know how many people know this, folks, but the diaphragm is the biggest muscle in the body. It's huge. It's a great sheet of muscle.
Especially on Elvis.
Especially on Elvis, right. And to do his voice and to keep control of that sort of emotional ferocity through 2.5 hours, the diaphragm's working all the time, very, very hard. So to have the biggest muscle in your body going flat out for 2.5 hours is exhausting. And there's all this stuff around the neck because his voice is down there. It's a different kind of voice altogether. And to do that, I've got to change the shape of my throat muscles. So that's the physical effort. And then there's all the emotional stuff, the turmoil.
So it's not just a change of accent, it's a change of voice and timbre and everything.
It's chase, yes, voice, timbre, it's the mental thing, you know. I mean, there's an awful lot of weeping and crying goes on. There's an awful lot of anger and a lot of laughter and stuff as well.
Yes.
But it just, It really does run the gamut from A to Z of just about everything I've got.
Is this why you described it as the performance as, or the role as an operatic role?
It is, yes. It is sort of operatic. Mm. I mean, I hope it's more than operatic in truthfulness and in intensity. I mean, I don't mean that to put opera down, but opera's not renowned for its realism. And this is as large as opera, but while still keeping track of realism and economy.
All right, we've got a clip of Martin from the show, from the London show, or the British show. Have a look at this.
Are you lonesome tonight? Do you miss me tonight? Are you sorry when drifting apart? Does your
if the audience, did you notice the shots of Martin in there with those still shots? Could you tell the difference between Martin and Elvis? You could.
I would imagine so, yes.
They're the two, that one. The first one was, the first one not so much. Now what about the voice, of course, was your voice.
Yes.
Did you regard yourself as a singer before this?
Not really, no. I don't now, either. It's.
But you did record an album.
Oh yes, we recorded the album. That's from the album. I mean, that song is—it's sort of like a death speech in a way. I mean, that when I don't actually sing that in the show, but when we came to do the album sort of tells the story. And we thought, how are we going to get over the fact that Elvis is dying here? So what happens is that on the album, as you've just heard, I sing that first bit, and then just where you cut it there, sweetheart. It's about the point where I keel over in the chair, which is when young Simon Bowman, who played the Elvis, the young Elvis,
right,
takes up the song. And then you get this juxtaposition between the old and the young, you see.
Is it a musical? I mean, how would you describe it overall? I mean, you've mentioned humor, you've mentioned music, you've mentioned opera. I mean, what category does it fit?
We never thought so, you see, because we never thought it was a musical. You, normally, when you have a musical, you have songs that have been specially written for the musical, you know. We didn't do that. So we were all astonished when we won the award for the best musical. So we said, hey, fellas, we are doing a musical, you know. So, but it's not really a musical. It's a very intense, emotional play. And there's probably more songs in it than most musicals, having
yes.
said that. But it's that they're all songs that have already been written. Also, there's another convention that musicals have that we don't, is that people sing at each other. You know, they say, like, we see Bobby, some enchanted evening. See, we don't do that. We're just doing the play, and then when the music comes in, I say, I want to see myself. I want to see 1958. Put it up, and it goes up on the screen, you see, and we see the younger Elvis. So it's like me watching myself. So it's more rational when the music comes in than it would be in a musical.